isn't this world a great, big, beautiful place? What a wonderful world we live in! As the trees are green, the red roses too, I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world, what a wonderful world. Your voice is terrible, you should see a doctor. Hurry up, follow me. I want to show you something. This way! You know what makes the world so special? Colors, colors, colors! I'm sure you would agree with me that the brightest, most beautiful colors can be found on flowers. Flowers are bright. They're soft. And some of them are so fragrant. Well, I think not all of them are. Wowee, morning glories everywhere! That's his way of reminding me that I have a story just for you. It's a story about what else? A morning glory. Pretty, aren't they? Do you know there are yellow ones too? Really, they are! Here, let me show you. There, you see? Now you believe me. But before the story begins, I want to take you on a little trip. Come on, follow me.
I'm gonna go with you!
That'll keep quiet. Okay, I'll go and change and I'll meet you there. Come on. If you want to see lots of different flowers, then you should visit your local florist or go and visit your local flower nursery, like this one here. Come on! I'm an expert on the names of flowers. For instance, this one here is a daisy. This one here is a canna. Ah, chrysanthemums. Begonias. And of course, the rose. This is the bougainvillea. This is the sexy pink. This is the coxcomb, and that is the axora. And these are some of our beautiful Malaysian orchids. And these are some cute petunias. This flower looks strange, doesn't it? Well, do you know what it's called? It's called the Deontorium.
the hibiscus, and the lantana.
The jasmine is one of the sweetest smelling flowers in the world.
Do you know there are also beautiful flowers growing in water? You want proof? Come on, I'll show you. This is the water lily. And the lotus. If you're planning to grow flowers, then the hibiscus is one of the flowers you should grow, because it is our national flower. Apart from being beautiful, it also comes in a variety of colors. Flowers, flowers everywhere. Oh gosh, what's that I see?
I'm sorry to startle you,
but what's the name of that flower?
This one?
Yes.
Oh, it's an alamander. It's beautiful, but its sap is really poisonous.
Okay, thank you. I knew that. I was just testing him.
Yeah, right. Where's the story?
And how on earth did he escape? Well, I'll be. I clean forgot about that old story. So here it comes. It's a story about them good old garden flowers. It's called Mr. Morning Glory. And since I'm such a mean boy, I'm gonna let y'all see just a little bit of it. And damn it, I'll be.
She was here yesterday. I saw her on the fence. Where could she be now?
We know. We saw her too.
Let her do something. Let's look for her.
I think the wither bush has something to do with this.
I was once hidden by it and nobody could find me for days.
Huh? Oh dear! Don't cry! I know! Let's get her from Captain Coconut Tree!
Yes!
Let's go! Captain Coconut Tree! Captain Coconut Tree! Where are you? We need your help!
What's wrong, my friends? You look very worried.
Oh dear, our friend Morning Glory is missing. We don't know where she is. Please help us look for her.
Don't cry. I shall help you. I like Morning Glory too. She brightens my day. There she is! It's Boo Boo! He is pulling her away!
Help! Help! Help!
Huh? Quickly! 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 Let's tell our friend somebody here to help us! Hurry! Hurry! Hurry!
Hurry! Hurry! Hurry!
Tunisia is a land of colors. Far as the eye can see, its beauty painted in its flowers that grow for you and me. Flowers will surely brighten your day, like rainbows falling from the sky, and like color drops along your way, they'll make your spirit fly. So that's what flowers can do, make you smile when you're feeling blue. Flowers for me, colors for you, and everyone else too. Flowers for me, colors for you, and everyone else too. Malaysia, my rainbow nation, a land where we make dreams come true. Show the world we're truly Malaysian. Malaysia, we love you.
Let's make Malaysia a beautiful rainbow nation, a color station where the formula is a flower called love.
So that's what flowers can do, make you smile when you're feeling blue. For you and everyone else too. Flowers for me, colors for you, and everyone else too. Malaysia, we love you.
Well, I'm back. Do you like the story so far? Poor Morning Glory. Isn't Boo Boo Bush just awful? He's a bad, bad bush. Anyway, do you know what pollination is? Pollination? No? Well, it is the process when the pollen grain goes from the anther onto the stigma, either inside the flower or from flower to flower. You don't know what I'm talking about, do you? Well, here. This is called the pollen grain. It goes from the anther and onto the stigma like this. Or it goes from the anther onto another flower. This. Well, and how does this happen? The flower gets help from wind, water, and little insects like this one.
You know that not all flowers grow on small bushes? Well, they also grow on tall trees. Like this one, for example. It's called the frangipani. It's beautiful, but sap is very poisonous. Here, take a closer look. You want to see another tall tree with pretty purple flowers? Well, my friends, come this way. Well, here it is. It's called the jacaranda. Flowers need sunshine. And they also need water. I just had to say water. Me and my big mouth. Oh, thank you. Okay, what else do we know about flowers? They're used on birthdays, teachers' days, Mother's Day, Valentine's Day, and even funerals.
We know that! Now tell us the story!
Oh gosh, even brought his friends along? I give up. You win. Okay, here's the rest of the story.
We must go all out to help them. Like they say, a friend in need is a friend indeed. And in this case, Boo Boo Bush learned his lesson. But Samad was happy because he had saved Morning Glory. Captain Coconut Tree could continue his sleep. And most of all, Morning Glory's friends were glad to have her back again. Well, I guess they all lived happily ever after. Okay, before I go, I want to leave you something very special. Have you ever seen a green flower? Well, I have found one for you. Thanks for spending your time with me. I hope you've learned something about Malaysian flowers. Try a new hobby. Try planting flowers. They will brighten up your garden and add colors to your life. Bye.
Okay, my friends, I'm sure you remember
all the flowers that we mentioned in the world of colors. And if you don't worry, because we are going to take a look at them again. Here they come. Sunflower. Rose. Marigold. Morning Glory. Daisy. Canna. Chrysanthemum. Ixora. Bougainvillea. Orchid. Petunia. Jasmine. Anthurium. Jacaranda. Frangipani. Alamanda. Lantana. Water lily. Lotus. Begonia. Coxcomb. Hibiscus.
Those were the flowers that you saw in the program. Here are a few more pretty ones that I think you should know about. Adenium. Goxenia. Carnation. Balsam.
And now for some fun with quiz time! I'm going to give you 6 questions. All you need to do is to choose the correct answer. Give yourself 2 points for each correct answer. Are you ready? Are you ready? And the first question is, what is the national flower of Malaysia? And the answer is hibiscus! Question number 2. Which of these is a very sweet-smelling flower? If C is your answer, then you get 2 points! Coming up, question number 3. It grows in water. Lotus? Did you say lotus? Correct! And for number 4, which of these flowers grow on tall trees? And the answer is frangipani! Coming up, the 5th question. It creeps on the ground and on fences. It is the if you choose Morning Glory, then you get 2 points! And the final question is simply this. Flowers need sunshine. Well, here's hoping that you got them all correct. And now, here's your chance to get down to some serious grammar work. We're going to work with prepositions. Prepositions are words like
on, in, under, near, onto, behind, round, against, next to, over, and in front of. They help us know the position of a person or a thing in relation to another. So, look at the visuals and try to fill in the blanks with any correct preposition. Happy trying!
Malaysia.